But I think America needs to change directions. We're the country that began with limited government, fleeing oppression, and now we're welcoming oppression to ourselves. We're the people that created free speech, and now we're afraid of free speech. We need to take our country back and turn it into the economic engine of prosperity and freedom that created the American dream, that created the opportunities that I had, and I want all of you young people to have, that you have the opportunity to live your life, prosper in a country that is free and safe for you.
Why is it so scary for you to have, possibly have Hillary Clinton as president?
Do we have 4 hours? She represents just about everything I don't. And I think I can speak for a lot of our friends that would agree with that. We represent life. She doesn't. We represent honesty. She represents some form of criminality. We represent honesty with the American people about the difficulties we face, as Dr. Carson alluded to, our debt, our mortgaging of our future, our robbing of the next generation like you all of the opportunity to succeed. She represents more government domination and taking away the individual initiative that has created the unique experience we call America.
How does that apply to Southwest Florida? What can be done to improve our situations as far as health, water, employment, tourism? What can be done on a local level?
Well, first and foremost, we've got a water problem. That water problem is in part and parcel a political clout problem. 16 years ago, the SERP was passed. 68 projects. At the time, it was several billion dollars. Now it's going to cost a lot more. The state of Florida has forked over a lot of money to do their part. The federal government has not. We need a strategy, we need a business-like approach to unite this community, to get all the people who have an interest in the water problem, to come up with a clear and decisive mission and message to take to Washington to convince people all around the country that are competing for projects in other states that our Everglades is a national infrastructure priority. And it boils my blood that people talk about the Grand Tetons and they'll talk about some mountain out in Nevada. And here we can't get that same level of interest over what is an ecological treasure. That's first and foremost for me.
Dr. Carson, what are you going to do specifically once, if you're elected, about our water problem?
First thing, again, I want to convene all the smart people in Lee and Collier County that feel passionately about this and have either scientific knowledge or experiential knowledge that can come together to help craft a message that can go to Washington and compete on the field with every other project around the country that's fighting for those same scarce dollars. Obviously, whatever we've been doing the last 16 years has not worked because we haven't gotten the money. And that gets into a few other collateral areas of working to use my business experience of bringing people together to solve real problems, to try to unite the Florida delegation behind our effort. You know, everybody in Florida has estuary remediation issues, water remediation issues, has flood insurance issues, and beach erosion issues. We need to unite together to be the ecological state and have our important state treasures, led by, of course, the Everglades and Lake Okeechobee, be respected nationally. And I think also, if I might, the last thing, I want to bring the decision makers from around the country down here, okay? They all know about the Grand Tetons because they go out to Jackson Hole or somewhere. I want them coming down here, getting out on a boat with me on Lake Okeechobee, going down the waterway like I have for about 25 years, getting out in the river of grass, seeing some snakes and some bugs. That's what I want them to do, to realize that this is nature at work.
And it's a little premature, but if you win this congressional seat, can you name some of the committees that you'd be willing to sit on? Or subcommittees?
Well, that'd be a little premature. I'm Irish, okay. You know, we have a lot of superstitions about being Irish that we don't want to count, as my mother used to say, count our horses before they come or something. I get mixed up. But whatever it takes to get that water, I'm on it 100%.